We do. That's exciting stuff. Discover Newport has brought us Chef Tim Souza from Tavern on Broadway. And man, let everyone know what you're making. Because this is your creation.
Yes, it is. Today we're going to make a chocolate bacon ice cream bar. So pretty classic combination of sweet, salty.
If you like ice cream, if you like bacon, this is the recipe for you. Now tell us the inspiration behind this, because you said you actually went next door to the coffee shop that was next door, right?
Yeah, and they had a bacon mocha coffee drink, and I just kind of sat with me all day, and at night I was cooking, and I was like, man, I got to try and make something out of this.
Is that how things come to you? Is it one of these things where you need a little inspiration, almost like a designer or something like that, and then you're able to create things?
I recently discovered Pinterest, and it's my new best friend.
Yeah.
You just see all these images, and they pop in your head, and then you'll be cooking like a week later, and you'll just be like, hey, I can throw this together,
and it works. You said this is easy to do.
Very simple.
So even the ice cream part of it shouldn't like freak you out.
No, unless you're making your own ice cream, which is a whole other task.
Right.
So basic ingredients, you've got chocolate, heavy cream, cooked crumbled bacon, a couple strips of cooked bacon, caramel sauce, which you can make or buy, vanilla bean, and then vanilla and chocolate ice cream, which I had to leave in the freezer so it doesn't melt while we talk about it.
But what type of morsels have we used in the chocolate cup?
Bittersweet and milk chocolate.
Okay, so you gotta blend them together.
50-50, and you blend them together. And then just regular heavy cream, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, bacon, so many different choices of bacon. What works best for this? And I guess you're gonna chop it up pretty fine.
That'll go in the cream with the chocolate to make the base, and then we'll layer another layer of whole bacon on top. I use applewood smoked bacon. It just is a nice flavor, kind of a little more complexity, but you can use whatever you want. Just regular plain bacon would be fine. But
right.
The thicker the better for more texture in there.
Got it. Okay. All right. Well, it looks good. If you like ice cream, and really, who doesn't? And if you love
bacon,
you've come to the right place today. We're going to blend them all together and make something fantastic that he says you can make it at home, and it's pretty easy. Back to you.
To Michaela in the kitchen.
Thanks, Brennan. Yeah, back to our bacon chocolate ice cream bar with Chef Tim. Discover Newport was so gracious enough to bring you in from Tavern on Broadway. And it already smells so good in here. How can you go wrong? Bacon, chocolate, I love it.
That's what I figured. I did the math and it all pointed towards tastes good. So right now we're just going to make the ganache, which is the heavy cream and bacon.
Yeah, what have you got started in this pan right here?
So right in here it's just heavy cream, crumbled bacon, and vanilla bean. Bring it to a simmer, and then you just pour it right over there. You can go ahead and stir a little bit.
Are these dark chocolate chips, milk chocolate, or is your preference?
It's a mixture of milk chocolate and bittersweet. So I'm going to get in here with the whisk a little bit.
Okay. Is that important to keep in mind if you are making something like this, to choose the bittersweet chocolate? Because sometimes if people just want to snack on it, they might not really go
for the bittersweet. Yeah, I like to blend the two because it mellows out the bitterness of the bittersweet chocolate. So if you went all bittersweet, it might kind of be a little bit too much bitter.
Okay.
The milk chocolate also allows it to become a little softer when you freeze it. So the first batch I actually did, I did do all bittersweet.
So it won't, break your teeth.
Yeah, exactly. We still have to serve it with a knife at the restaurant because it's a big chunk of frozen ice cream and bacon and chocolate. So
yum.
This is good. We're just going to pour this right into this pan right here, and then we're going to go ahead and refrigerate it. So it becomes...
Oh, that's right. I'm trying to whisk it until the chunks are up, but I'm forgetting that there's
bacon inside.
That's the bacon.
Yep. So this will go right in the fridge, and then we'll put bacon and caramel, and then a layer of vanilla ice cream and a layer of chocolate ice cream.
How long should we let that chill for?
It's about an hour, but I've actually got one pre-made for later on in the show. I'll show you how to cut it, and it'll be all assembled, and then we get to try it.
Nice.
This
is an easy dessert, too, that I bet even like kids can help out with at home.
Yeah, it's very simple, and the beauty is you can exchange the ingredients, too. It's just like an ice cream layer bar, and it's really fun to do for a party or to bring to someone's house for a holiday or something like that.
How would this work with white chocolate? Because I know that sometimes temperatures range, but would it still work?
It would still work. You'd have to probably adjust the amount of cream and stuff like that because white chocolate tends to be a little bit softer, so you would probably add less cream.
Got it.
But you could
stick with the dark and milk chocolate.
Yeah, this is a good recipe, but you could always put white chocolate over there if you wanted to.
Yum.
Anything your heart desires.
Oh, we're going to have some fun here in the kitchen. We are going to finish up this incredible dessert coming up a little later on in the show.
We're back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Discover Newport has brought a Chef Tim Souza from Tavern on Broadway chocolate bacon ice cream bar. So if ice cream wasn't good enough, if bacon wasn't good enough, you, my friend, have blended them both together and come up with this.
Yes, this is my new creation.
This is the ultimate dessert.
It is. I love ice cream and I love bacon, can't go wrong. So far we've got the ganache in the bottom and the bacon and the caramel in there. And then the next step is just take your vanilla and chocolate ice cream. Let them sit out for like 5-10 minutes. So
that way you can...
Yeah, it's not a rock. And then you can... I see I kind of push them down a little bit. So we're just going to take it, see how it's nice and soft.
Right.
So what you've done since we last left you is the mixture that we made, it obviously froze, and then you layered full pieces of bacon.
Full pieces of bacon first, and then the caramel right on top of that.
Nice.
So I'm just going to gently spread it, and it's kind of a messy process, so you don't need to be perfect about it. And you just kind of spread it out until the ice cream and everything just oozes together.
Kind of blends together.
Yep.
Wow.
And then you're going to put this in the freezer and let it solidify. I would let it sit for a day in a freezer at your house.
Okay.
Because we have an industrial freezer that blows like, you know, negative 10 degrees. I doubt your freezer's that cold. So we'll go ahead and put that away.
Okay.
And what I've done is I have one that I prepared at the restaurant. And this is exactly how I have it there.
Nice.
And you can see it's just this big layered bar.
Now that's not the serving size, is
no,
it?
No. So what I do is I cut it down like this, and then I just cut it right into a... nice little
layers.
Yeah, it's kind of pretty looking, and someone pointed out it kind of does look like a off-colored piece of bacon.
It does look like an off from this side, yeah.
Yep. So at the restaurant, I'll put that on the plate with some salted caramel and just some crumbled chocolate cake crumbs.
Wow.
So at the end product ends up looking like this.
Look at that.
That is beautiful.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's only $6. It's definitely a dessert to share. I mean, I couldn't eat that whole thing by myself. Well, I'm lying about that.
But there's a lot going on in there.
Yeah, there's a lot going on, and people tend to be weary of ordering it, but the people that have ordered it loved it.
Good.
So you can get that on our menu right now.
Uh-huh.
And
you have a lot of other great things happening.
You got a lot going on.
Yeah, so on top of the bacon ice cream bar, which is fabulous, we have, we're going to be in the chili cook-off and the wing cook-off for Winterfest down in Newport, which there's a lot of great other things going on for the family. There's music and art and entertainment.
And you said the beef that's coming in is coming in from?
It's coming from New England grass-fed beef. This guy, Pat Beck, he called me and said he'd like to donate some beef to cook off in the chili. So it's 100% local. It's grass-fed. These cows are like treated like kings. They have a whole big pasture.
Right. It's going to be some good chili.
Yeah, so it's going to be some really good chili. And I'm going to try and source all the ingredients locally as well, the beans and all that stuff, the onions, everything else that's going to go into it.
I'd like to hear that.
So I think we got a good shot at that.
And the restaurant hasn't been open for too long, but you guys are doing great.
No, yeah. About 6 months, and I really can't ask for more. We've been doing really well. We just did some light renovations. We've got some great live music on the weekends. And yeah, business has been very well.
That's fantastic.
Nice.
Yeah.
This is something, too, that it's not just special. This is on the menu.
Yes, it's on the menu, and I think it's going to be there to stay for now. Maybe not in the 90-degree summer weather. I don't know how that'll stand.
Right. But you know what?
You never know.
Sometimes
happen
you want
too.
A nice, cool treat when it's that hot out.
Especially with bacon in it.
Right.
Well, God. You want to? I know you're eyeing.
You go. Okay.
You're
you
I like eyeing everything, but I'm gonna have some of this.
Give that
go ahead
a
and
whirl.
Dig in.
And I'm gonna dig in over here.
That looks delicious.
Yeah, we usually serve it with a steak knife, actually, because
that bottom
layer
is. I was gonna say it's a little hard to get through the bacon.
I can cut you off a few slices.
You don't leave out that bacon, Will. If you're gonna try it, you gotta
go for
it.
You?
Yum.
You want a piece?
Oh yeah.
All
cut me up a slice of that.
Sounds
all right. If you want this recipe, so you can make your own bacon chocolate ice cream bar at home, head on over to our website, WPRI.com.
Thank you.